Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, make sure you subscribe before you go. It's not good not to subscribe. Subscription is free. Let's not get into that right now. But thank you guys for coming back again. Thank you for watching all our videos and liking it. It's good because this channel is where we talk about family, business, and lifestyle. So we'll drop it from time to time. And from time to time in the video, you'll be seeing my only one and only chest coming around. I've decided that there's no how we're going to film or shoot, that she's not going to be a part of it. So if you do hear her cries here and there, please bear with us. That's how they are. That's what they are in this life for. This video, I'll be talking about how I landed a job in my first 2 weeks in Canada. So I arrived Canada, I moved to Canada in 2018, arrived in July, and my first 2 weeks actually landed a really good job. And I know it's one of the major things when people travel or when people migrate, you want to obviously settle down quickly, you want to have everything all sorted. One of the big things you're looking out for is actually finding a job. I've also realized that when people move to places like Canada, because of the overwhelming culture shock or mentality change, it's very difficult to kind of get into the market just because of small few tips that we don't know. So I'm going to be dropping some of these tips that helped me kind of navigate the job market and get me to where I am. Presently, I'm in Manitoba, Winnipeg, in Canada. My work experience background, I have some background in engineering, some in software management. In the travel industry, I also have some experience there. I've started a couple of companies, businesses should I say, both in Nigeria and in the UK when I was living there. So I have quite some experience in multiple sectors and industries, which is also an asset, and I'll get to that in a few seconds. So I actually just tabled my top five things that I think you need to understand and know when you're applying for a job in Canada. My top five things. Now, this might not be the only things, there might be more things, but these are like my top five things that I think if you understand it so well, then you have no problem in the job market in Canada. Number one, it is resume, not CV. Now, it might just be a language thing, however, it is a huge thing in the Canadian market. It is resume, not CV. It might not have been a problem for you if you've tried and you've gotten a job writing CV on it, but it is resume. They actually recognize the word resume, and it's actually a huge thing, language related. So when you're writing your CV, everything you want to write in it, especially when you save it, because some of us have CVs already that we've saved on our computers, and then when we edit it, we now save it again as the same thing. And no, make sure you change it to resume. Is a big thing. Number two, job titles are not always what they seem. I've had this conversation with people a lot. When they write operations manager, for instance, it totally differs. Like the job title, you need to dig deep into the roles and responsibilities for you to really understand what the title, what the job role is about. Sometimes it differs from industry to industry. So some industries have it as operations manager, some other industries have it as office manager. Like literally the job title might not be what it seems. Some people would say marketing coordinator, some people would say marketing managers. You need to dig deep into the responsibilities to really understand what it's about. Number three, how long is your leg? There's some people that will really already understand what I'm trying to say. But really, the question is, how long is your leg? In Canada, it's really, really important for you to have an internal reference. It might not be important every time, but trust me, it's a plus. So if you can get an internal reference, it is super encouraged for you to get one. When you're applying and then you say, oh, how did you hear about us? Put the name of the person. If you can get the HR manager, the hiring manager, the recruiter manager, and you can actually get them on LinkedIn, so that these tools are actually good tools, especially LinkedIn. I wasn't a big fan of LinkedIn before now, but then because based on what I do now, I have to kind of research on people before I communicate with them, because I want to know the integrity first. And LinkedIn is a great place to find it, to message these people and to have a communication with them. And it's okay to actually ask how the recruitment process is going. In Canada, you can. You can actually say, oh, what's going on with my application? I applied 2 weeks ago. They will tell you. Like, that's another thing you need to understand. So, how long is your leg? Number four, agencies are fun. There are loads of agencies. Now, companies in Canada, as much as I know, most of them, some of them don't have in-house HR departments, except like the huge corporations that can fund theirs. So most of them actually outsource to agencies. There are loads of agencies all around Canada, depending on your province and your region. There's some that are obviously scattered all around Canada in itself. So yeah, get into agencies, apply with agencies, go in there yourself. It's totally okay to walk in and tell them that you are looking for a role, you're looking for a job, and you can drop your resume and they can help you put things together and obviously put you through when roles and jobs come through. Number five, every experience is an experience. You built a house for your uncle, construction experience. You sold pure water for your mom in their shop, sales and marketing experience. You worked on a project in university for your final year project, project management experience. I'm telling you these things, it's not even a joke. Every experience is an experience. You did an internship in the place for 2 weeks. Experience. It's huge. Because one of the major things that Canadian employers look for is experience. As much as your GPA is this one, whatever your GPA is, experience is a big thing. They want to know that you can do what you say you can do. And they want to see a track record of you doing it. Obviously, let's not get to the part where they always ask for Canadian experience, which, to be honest, sometimes can be very difficult for new immigrants because you're thinking, I just arrived yesterday. How do I want to have Canadian experience? However, you can actually use your own experiences that you've gathered over the years and obviously make sure your resume reflects to the best of your abilities, your core experiences. Now, this is not a video where I will talk about CVs and how and the different types of resumes that they are and the different ways to actually put your resumes. I'll put that in another video and which you can watch later. But basically, these are my top five things. Resume, not CV. I still say CV sometimes and people look at me like, what are you talking about? But yeah, it's resume. Job titles are not always that important. How long is your leg? Like I said, agencies are fun. You can get into one of them. And experiences are experiences. Now to my story. So my first week of arriving in Canada, I think I arrived on a Thursday evening. Like I said, fresh out of the block, came down with my one Ghana Must Go and one jeans. And no, it wasn't like that. But yeah, basically it was something like that. I just want jeans because I don't wear a lot of jeans. I just have. Moving on. So I arrived and then I think Friday I think that Thursday night, I already brought up my laptop. I'm like, we're doing this. We're finding job tomorrow. I'm not woo. But then, obviously, it kind of took a couple of time. On Friday, I went to do my SIN, apply for my SIN in Service Canada, and I tried to get my medical card. Basically, do all the normal things you do when you just land and arrive. And then, my major drive was I need to get a job. I need to get a job soon. It was a weekend, so I couldn't do anything anyways, so I chilled. However, going into the week, the Monday, I started to apply vehemently, and I would go out of town, and I would go out to see what was available. I was asking a lot of questions. I landed with my cousin, so I was asking a lot of questions. What was available? What could I do? Where could I apply to? And that's where I came across Manitoba Start. Now, I had said before that agencies are fun. Agencies are things you want to go to. Most provinces have these new immigrant programs where you can actually apply to and get information. So most of the information you're actually looking for, most of them are already gathered by some of these agencies or some of these groups or these not-for-profit organizations that operate in the regions. Okay, Mama, come here. Come here. Come and join this video. Ah, great. That operate in these regions. And so basically, I started to do some of them and I applied to this Manitoba Start. This was on the Monday towards Tuesday. Now on Thursday, I had to come back to drop my proof of address and some of the other things I needed to do. And don't get distracted by this face. Look here and listen to what I'm saying. So I just finished from Manitoba Start. I was walking down the road. Now that road had a lot of agencies on that road. And I walked through. I believe it was the Holy Spirit that just said, you know what? Why not just walk into one of them? I had my resume printed already. I was prepared. And I walked into this one. It was called. And I just asked a few questions. Oh, I'm looking for a job, blah, blah, blah. This is what I'm looking for to do. And the guy kept asking, what's your experience? What's your background like? I think he initially asked, oh, when did you arrive? And I said, like, last week. And then he's like, oh, okay, what's your experience? And I told him everything, where I'd worked, what I was doing. He asked what I was looking for. I said I was looking for something more corporate, more office-based, and not casual. And then he's like, okay, he thinks he has something. Then he brought out the file, and he's like, oh, I have something that is travel-related. Did you say you had a travel experience? I'm like, oh, yeah, I worked in a travel firm, and I tabled all my experiences, and basically, and he called me for an interview the very next day, Friday. And so I came in for the interview, and that was it. The only thing I needed to prove was the fact that I had worked in the travel industry. I understood travel and tour, and tourism and tours. And this company I started working with initially for my first job in Canada was a tourism company, was a tour company that had operated for over 50 years in Winnipeg, and they were looking for a business developer, and it was just amazing. And that's literally how I landed my first job in the second week of me arriving in Canada. It was like magic. But some of the things that I'd obviously, apart from the fact that God really stepped in to help, I put some of these things forward, and some of the tips I just counted out to you, the fact that I was intentional about it, I put my core competencies up front, my experiences were tabled up front, I tailored everything I was doing towards the role in itself, and it was not just, I was not just putting whatever I had out there, and I was really, really intentional about it, and that's how I got this job. And that's the end of my video today. If you enjoyed that, please subscribe. Like I said, this vlog is really about family, lifestyle, and business, and career on the side, and I'll be bringing out things going forward on how to help people settle into Canada, and settle in when you just migrate to anywhere in the world, really. And on the final note, okay, mama, come on, join us. Come.
Hey, babe.
Come. She's about to move the camera now. So if it's moving, Elijah is the one doing it. It's not me. I didn't do anything. But thank you guys for watching. I hope to see you in the next video. Click, subscribe, share, like, do all those fantastic. She's still doing it. She's moving it. All right. Bye-bye before she drops. See you guys later. Bye.